For the green screen editing class, we're going to go into Corel Photo Paint, and you can find that in your Start menu under the Graphics and Drawing section. The icon looks like a white circle with a red camera on the front of it. And when opening the software, if you get to a registration page, you can always say skip. You don't have to register the software every time for this makerspace. Now, once you're into Corel Photo Paint, it will look very similar to your Corel Draw software. You've got your drop-down menu at the top and your standard toolbar right under it. And then we've got our rotating toolbar at the bottom of that. On the left-hand side, we've got our design tools, our art space in the middle, and our object manager on the right side. So we are going to go to File, Open, and we're going to open a photo of someone on our green screen background. The very first thing we're going to do is come over to our Object Manager and right-click our Background tab and make a duplicate of that background so that we can work on an object layer and not our background. I'm actually going to right-click on my background layer and lock it so that I can't work on it at all. Then I'm going to click on my object layer so that it is highlighted in blue, and I know that is the layer that I am currently editing. Now we're going to go over to our design tools and select the rectangle mask tool. I'm going to click on the caret in the corner so I can see the flyout menu of all the tools nested under that mask tool. And the one I'm going to start with is our magic wand mask. That magic wand mask has changed our cursor now to a nice little magic wand. And what this tool does is it selects all the pixels that are of a similar color. Now, when I click on the green, it's going to select a big section of that green. But every time I click, it's going to make a new selection and delete my old selection. So I want to make sure I come up to my rotating toolbar, and right here at the very left side of it, I've got my modes. Right now I'm in normal mode, but I want to be in additive mode, that green plus sign, so that every time I click, I add to my selection instead of deleting my old one. So now I'm just going to continue clicking in my green, and anywhere I see these little marquee dots in my green background, I'm going to keep clicking on them to try to add them to my selection. My goal is to get this marquee line around my subject's body as closely as possible without any gap. So like I said, anywhere I see these marquee lines or unselected green space, I'm going to keep clicking on the background and try to add that in. Don't forget all the places where that green background can hide, like between your arms and your torso, little tiny spaces between your hand and your fingers. If you have glasses, sometimes it can be hidden in the little glare of your glasses or in your hoop earrings. Don't forget to use your zoom tools to really get in close to see those pixels and all that little green space. Now I think I've gotten it as good as I can get it with my magic wand tool. So I'm going to go over to my mask tools in my design toolbar and hit my caret again to see my flyout. And I'm going to choose the freehand mask. With that freehand mask tool, I can click and drag a lasso selection around multiple areas, like these little dots in the middle here. And I can double click to select them all at once. For spaces away from my person, I can do that for the ceiling by clicking and dragging a lasso around big areas and selecting it all at once to add to my background selection. Because I want to select everything except for my subject. I'm going to do the same thing for the floor. I'm going to zoom in close so that I don't accidentally get his feet. Now, the freehand mask is also good for places like shadows under your feet, where I've got this little area I want to add in to my background. So I'm going to draw along my subject and select that area and add it to my selection. I'm going to do the same thing on his toes and just get those little shadows. Now, if for instance I had accidentally selected a piece of my subject, I just need to remember to change my mode from additive to subtractive, and then I can go back in and add that little piece I missed. Once I have my selection as good as I think I want it, and my marquee line is going just around the edge of my subject and the outside of my picture, I'm going to go to my mask dropdown, and I am going to invert my selection. So I'm going to swap it from the background selection to selecting just my person. Oh, and once I do that, I always see things I missed, like this little piece of the floor. Now I want to make sure this time when I go back to clean up my selection that I'm in the subtractive mode because I'm getting rid of my selection, not adding to it. There are a couple pieces I missed between his feet and along the edges. Anywhere you have shadows in your background, you're probably going to find pieces of selection that didn't get added in for some reason. So go in and clean that up. I like doing the invert option so that I can always see those pieces I missed and I make sure my selection is as good as possible. That looks good to me. So once we're at this point, all we need to do is right click on our subject and copy. And then I'm going to right click again and paste as a new object. And now I can see over in my object manager that I have my object 2, my new layer, and I can tell I have no background, but I'm just going to close the eye on my object 1 and background layers so I can really see what my cutout selection looks like. At this point, I can go up to my mask dropdown and I can remove that selection marquee so I just see my person.